Hello, today's video is on retail, the retail stage of the production and consumption cycle that we'll be studying in our stuff project for social studies. So in this video, we're mainly going to talk about different vocabulary for our first stage of stuff research, the retail stage. So the stuff project, we're just getting started with it. We're going to follow the journey of your stuff. So we just followed the movement of people in your heritage with our last project, the Stand in the Place Where You Are project. And now we're going to explore the movement of goods, or stuff, that we use. So we'll study the economy, which is how a place uses its resources, or the money a place earns, and we'll look more into that. And economics, which is the study of how resources are used. That includes natural resources, and also time. When we get into economics, how people use their time and the time it takes to build something, that's a resource. So following our stuff, we'll look at where our stuff comes from and what the prices were at each stage. This starts off pretty easy. Usually when you have something, it's because somebody bought it in the store. That's the retail stage, and we're going to look at the vocabulary for that right now. So some of the vocabulary around that, there's the consumer, which is someone who buys something for personal use. It's kind of the customer. And there's retail. Retail means that it's sold to the public. You, me, the average person. So we'll look at some different ways that things are sold later, but right now we're starting at retail, so that's just something that's sold in a store to the general public. A retailer, then, is someone who sells to the public. So any kind of store that actually sells things to the public. A retail price is the price that the public pays. Also, the suggested retail price, you may have heard that before. Maybe you've heard of MSRP, which is the manufacturer's suggested retail price. That's a price that the person who makes it, who makes the item, says it should be sold to the public. So we'll look kind of more into that in the next stages when we look at the manufacturer and who these retailers are actually buying from. But so know right now that the retail price is what the customer pays, what the general public pays. And also sale price, that's the reduced price. So if something's on sale, that's the sale price. I'm sure you're familiar with sales and seeing things for reduced price. So researching retail at this stage, it's pretty easy. A lot of the information is very easy to find. We can easily find out where the stuff came from because you can figure out which store it was bought in, and we can easily figure out the retail price because that information is widely available. So we can figure that out here. What's the retail price for this item? Very easy. The information is on display. It's very easy to find. It's $14.97. And you can tell, it doesn't say in this picture, but you can tell by some of the logos that this was at Walmart. So easily, it's easy to see the place that it came from, Walmart, and the retail price, the price that the general public pays, is $14.97. We can also look at a receipt and try and think, what is the retail price for this item? It's listed right on the receipt. So the information for this is very easy to find. It's displayed in the store. It's displayed on the receipts. So it's not too challenging. And we will practice this with some items this week. I'll give you some items, and we will practice finding the retail price and where it came from. Very simple. Starts off easy. Retail information is not hard to find. It's very easy to find because the customers and the consumers need to find it to buy things. So everybody wants to know what the price is, so it's out there. It's very easy to find, especially compared to some of the prices that we'll be looking at later when we're trying to find. So very easy this week. Just a little bit of vocabulary for you to learn.